वेलकम बैक चिल्ड्रन,
आर यू रेडी फॉर योर नेक्स्ट क्लास?
चिल्ड्रन टेल मी वन थिंग इन द चैट बॉक्स, आर यू टेकिंग एक्सरसाइज व्हाइल स्टेइंग होम टू कीप योरसेल्फ एक्टिव, और यू आर जस्ट ईटिंग एंड स्लीपिंग एंड गेटिंग लेजी डे बाय डे? क्विकली आंसर मी इन द चैट बॉक्स। डू यू नो, Today, we are going to read a lesson about Rip Van Winkle, who was very lazy. So, open lesson 7, Rip Van Winkle, given on page number 45 of your English book. Rip Van Winkle was a lazy man. He slept the whole day. Children, Rip Van Winkle is the main character of the story and he was very lazy. He did nothing but he kept on sleeping the whole day. His wife tried her best to get Rip Van Winkle to take up a job. Now children, his wife was fed up of his nature, Rip Van Winkle's nature, and wanted him to do some work. She kept on forcing her husband to start doing some job. When he did get a job, he was asked to leave because he slept too much. And you know, whenever he started a job, he had to leave it because he slept even during his working hours. Thus, his master's asked him to leave the job. One day, Rip Van Winkle, tired of his wife telling him to get a job, ran up a mountain with his favorite companion, his dog. Children, as Rip's wife kept on asking him to work, Rip got frustrated. So he left his house and went to the mountains. He took his best friend, his dog, with him. He reached the top, crossed the stream, went to a spot where nobody ever came, and sat down there. He kept climbing up the hill and reached the top of the mountain. On his way, he crossed a small narrow river. Stream here means small narrow river. He reached a place which was not visited by anyone. That means no one had ever come there. He had never had so much exercise in his life. In his whole life, he had not walked that much. He was just getting back his breath when he heard someone call his name, Rip Van Winkle. Getting back his breath means breathing normally after taking exercise or after walking or running. Rip walked a long distance and sat to take rest. He started breathing normally when he heard his name. Strange. Nobody knows me here. Then, who is calling me? Thought Rip Van Winkle. He thought that he didn't know anyone there. Then who was calling him by his name? He turned around and saw a funny looking man carrying a big barrel. Barrel here means kind of drum, usually made up of wood. He looked here and there and found a strange man who was carrying a wooden drum on his shoulder as shown in the slide. The funny looking man said, "Please help me carry this barrel to my friends a little below the stream." So children, he asked Rip to help him carry that barrel or drum. He wanted to take that barrel to his friends. Rip and Winkle had climbed so far up the mountain to avoid work, and here was a man asking for help. Children, what a strange situation. He ran away from his house and came here so that he couldn't work, so that he should stay idle without work. And now somebody has come to ask for help. He first decided to refuse, but then he thought. Earlier, he thought to say no to that man, but later he thought, let me help the poor man, then I can rest. So he and the funny looking man walked down to a cave in the mountain below the stream. There, Rip and Winkle saw many other funny looking men. All of them were playing. They ignored him. Ignored him means they showed that they had not seen Rip and Winkle. As soon as the barrel was placed on the ground, the men pulled out their mugs, dipped them into the barrel, and drank something. It was a strange, sweet drink. Children, when Rip put the barrel on the ground, everyone took their mugs, filled them with some liquid from the barrel and drank it. Rip and Winkle too dipped a mug in the barrel and drank it. It tasted good. He had one more mug. After three mugs, he fell asleep. After drinking three mugs of that sweet and strange drink, Rip Van Winkle slept as usual. When he awoke, he saw that all funny looking men had gone. He called out to his dog, but there was no response. No response means no answer. That means when Rip called his dog, after getting up, he got no answer from his dog. He could not believe he had slept the whole day and night. He got up. His joints ached. His joints ached means he felt pain in his joints, like shoulders, elbows, knees. As he started walking back home, he saw the village down below, which somehow seemed changed. Children, he started climbing down the mountain to go back to his village. But when he saw his village while coming down, he found that his village looked different. It didn't look the same as he left. When he entered the village, he saw new faces. All the people looked at him and rubbed their chins. Seeing them do this, Rip Van Winkle did the same. To his surprise, he found that he had grown a foot long beard overnight. When he reached the village students, no one was known to him. Everyone was wondering that who he was, and while thinking, they scratched their chins. And when Rip did so, he found that in just one night, his beard got 1 foot long. Now, can you guess why was it happening? If yes, write the guess in the chat box why it happened. Rip Van Winkle was puzzled. He believed that he knew most of the village folks well, but today he could not see anyone who was known to him. Children, Rip was very shocked because when he left the village, he knew almost everyone. But When he came back, he was unable to find anyone familiar to him. The children made fun of him, running behind him. Rip Van Winkle stopped by a place where there had been a school and asked the crowd that had gathered, "Where is Schooner, the schoolmaster?" He asked about Schooner from the crowd, who was a schoolmaster. Somebody said, "Oh, Schooner, he went to war in 63 and never came back." In 63 means in the year 63. He went to the war, but he got lost there. He didn't come back. "And Vandemel?" asked Rip Van Winkle. Now he inquired about another man named Vandemel. He was another villager. "He died 18 years back," said another voice in the crowd. Rip Van Winkle thought, "Am I going mad? Have I slept all these years on the mountain?" Finally, Rip Van Winkle asked, "Does anyone here remember Rip Van Winkle?" A woman said, "Yes, he was my father. He went up the mountains 21 years back, but never returned. His dog came back without him." Rip Van Winkle was overjoyed. He said, "Daughter, it's me, Rip Van Winkle. Don't you recognize me?" Children Rip became very happy to see his daughter and told his daughter that he was Rip Van Winkle. "Oh, father, it is really you? Where have you been all this while?" asked his daughter. Now, children, even the daughter was very happy and asked her father, why didn't he come back for so many years? And she asked, where was he? Father and daughter hugged each other. Rip Van Winkle had indeed slept for 21 years. And do you know, children, where was he? Yes, he really slept for almost 21 years. Can you sleep for so long? No? But he slept for 21 years. Yes. So what have you learned from the chapter? We have learned that we should not be lazy. We should work hard and stay active. And I hope now you will work hard and read this chapter twice for better understanding. Goodbye. Take care. Stay safe. Stay home.